for speedy resolution of disputes, complaints in matters of standard of care, prices of services, negligence and unfair practices. Friends, India has to face a lot of challenges since independence. One among them is the health care for all. Health care has been a priority area for successive governments in India. And in case of many developing nations, India too had several issues to handle in the health care sector. The issues are low public health care spend, low doctor-patient ratio, low patient bed ratio, death of medical colleges and trained doctors, lack of penetration of health insurance, lower spend on rural health care, infrastructure, inadequate disease preventive mechanism, malnutrition in all age groups and sanitation. These are the major challenges that are faced by our nation. India spends about 4.2% of the GDP towards the health care, goods and services as compared to 18% of the developed nations. We are way behind. The government of India, presided over by the Prime Minister Sri Narendra Bhai Modi, he wants to focus more and more on medicine, medical education, because health will bring you wealth. But there is no guarantee that wealth can bring you health. So keeping that in mind, the government wants to focus more on health of the nation. Because of the change of a lifestyle, all of us are now undergoing through a great transformation of change of lifestyles. There is no physical activity at all. We are becoming more and more mechanical. That's why more and more diseases are coming. Literally, there is no place for any physical strain. Earlier, we used to go out. Now, we should not go out. I am Minister for Swachh Bharat, so I don't advocate open defecation. There is a toilet inside. Earlier, used to bend. Now there is no need to bend, you have come out. Earlier to take bath, you have to go to bathroom, now bathroom is inside. Earlier to fetch water, you have to bend down and take water, now there is a shower. Earlier to take food, you have to sit down, now you are sitting on a table. Earlier to wash your hands, you have to go out, now you have a finger bowl. Earlier to open the door, you have to go out and open the door, now you have a remote control. Earlier to open the car, you have to use your hand and then there is a remote now also. Earlier to speak on phone also, you have to go and then pick up the phone. Now phone is coming to you. Earphones are coming. Literally, and then literally, there is no physical activity at all. That's the major reason for many of the diseases that are really happening in the society. Second is now because of the change of culture, change of lifestyle, we are having tension and we are losing our attention towards the real developmental activities. Westernization has brought a lot of change in our life. But whatever our tradition, our culture, our heritage, which our forefathers has given to us, we must preserve it. We must feel happy about the traditions that have been given to us by our forefathers who have lived for years together and who have given us best practices. So that's why we must always remember, as students, my advice to all of you, the youngsters, doctors who are going to the field of medicine, my advice to all of you is please remember the culture, please remember the heritage, please remember the traditions, and also please remember the family. Because family is the best counseling. The grandmother, the grandfather, the mother, the father, the relatives in the house, but the family system is falling apart. One of the great strengths of India as a nation is the family system, the culture, the heritage, the way of living, which our great people have shown to us. But unfortunately, there's a rapid change is happening. We must revert back. We should not forget our roots. We must remember this great land has given us this something in our life. So friends, the private sector is a dominant healthcare provider in both urban and rural India households, while 32% of urban patients use public hospitals, 68% go to private establishment. Among rural patients, 32% are treated in public hospitals and remaining 58% use private ones. In a developing country like India, public sector has a critical role in ensuring healthcare delivery to all sections of the society. Number of physicians available per 10,000 of population is more than 20 in case of developed countries, while in India it is only 6. Country needs 10.5 lakh doctors, but we have only 6.5 lakh doctors. There is a huge deficit. Presently, there is one doctor per 1700 population in India. WHO norms is one doctor for 1,000. India should also aim at having one doctor for every 1,000. A high-level committee of planning commission, now Niti Aayog, recommends setting up of 187 more medical colleges by 2022. The Prime Minister is keen that to have one medical college for each district of the country.